I'm Justin Davis, and this is Drone Camps RC. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. Check out my Flybot Mini Race Wing. This thing is a super sleek 36 inch race wing that is compatible with something like a 30 to 60 amp speed controller, a 2205 motor. So if you have any 2205 motors laying around and something like a 6 inch prop on there, you can set up a FPV race wing that's actually pretty awesome. Now, I just recently bought an S800 to build, and that's sitting over there, still being worked on. We're working on FR Sky setup with some Omnibus F4 on there. So this one doesn't have a flight controller. It's purely manual. If you want to add a flight controller on this one and do some sort of long range stuff with this, you could. You can make a mini long range wing out of this because there are 3D printed mounts that you can put inside this Flybot race wing. But I left this one purely manual for you guys to build it, test it out, and set it up the way that I wanted it. Now, Flight Test also did a review of this, and their test was awesome. Cha-ching, always on the Flight Test guys, they're awesome. But this one has some, I think, better attributes to this one versus the S800. A lot of people love the S800, but this was just way easier to build and set up, mainly because all I really had to do was put together this carbon fiber fuselage, just like putting together a mini quad, very similar to that, and adding this adjustable motor mount back here, which is also super awesome. And, you know, just putting the hinges on back here for the control surfaces. And those are actually wooden. You have to drill in your own holes here with a Dremel for the servo linkage there, but not a big deal. And I'm running some servos that I stole off of another wing that have little 9 gram, those are 9 gram Technique Hobby servos, just some off-brand servo. And they're, I don't even think they're metal, but I would go with metal servos on a wing like this because it's going to have some super high G's. Now, this is all styrofoam here out on the wings. I did get one damaged part here and here. It seems that this wing came off and ran into the prop. That's probably one of the only drawbacks of this particular design. This wing is designed so that when it hits the ground, the wings actually pop off. And that is a pro and a con, mainly because every time that you toss this wing to tune it, because when you first toss this for the first time, it's not going to be trimmed out. And most people that fly airplanes know that the first maiden flight is always going to be kind of a challenging one because it's going to be flying to the left or it's going to be rising too much. You're going to have to give it down elevator and a lot of sub trim to get it trimmed out and flying in a straight line. So with that said, this was frustrating for me because every time it hit the ground during a toss, I would have to walk over and put the wings back on it. Now, every time it did hit the ground, I was afraid also that it was going to rip these leads off of my receiver. So the pins never came off. They just kind of bent a little bit, but I never had any kind of real hardcore heavy damage with this, even in my flight test. And I'll show you guys coming up soon that I actually spiraled in straight into the ground. I didn't intend to do a durability test, but you can see that this one took a straight on impact out in the field, and my camera survived and everything on here survived. Had a little damage on my VTX, but one pro or one con of this particular design might be that it's hanging out on the side. So if you guys build one of these, maybe try to put it along the body somewhere here or mount it underneath if you can, maybe with the antenna coming out the side, I don't know. But somewhere else rather than up front, possibly. But I did use a pretty cheap version of a 600 milliwatt transmitter here so that I could get max range. It's just not the greatest soldering, so I re-soldered everything, and now it's better than it was before. And also, if you're going to build one of these, I would definitely suggest using a 4S. This is an 850. You could probably go up to 4S 1300 on this wing. Now, CG is absolutely critical on this wing. You need a lot of weight forward. I actually took my run cam 2 off and tried to toss it without the run cam 2, and you can see all this weight. I even have an extra battery up here. This is an extra 3S 450 milliamp powering my FPV system, and that's totally something I don't need, but I added it on there anyway because I needed a lot of weight forward for this not to be tail heavy. And the adjustable motor mount just didn't quite, I had it pushed in all the way as far as I could get it, and it just didn't quite level out right. So I'm going to experiment with that a little more, but for now, this is pretty much the optimal setup. Now, it also has carbon fiber spars. You're going to need to glue these in when you build your kit. And they're not super hard, but it's critical that you measure them and get them to meet at the very center of these mounts. And they tell you how far to have them sticking out when you glue them in. Make sure they're not too far or too short. And you can see right here that it is separated right here from that last landing that I had. Every landing that you have with this wing, you're going to have a little bit of offset for the wing. So make sure that you take your driver tool and just loosen that up and push it back in before your next launch. And these, you can crank them down really, really tight. And I was afraid that I was going to break these carbon spars, but you know, these carbon spars are actually quite tough. They did not break during my testing, which was kind of amazing. Now, one thing I thought that was a little bit annoying about this kit is the fact that it did come with these driver bolts, star bolts instead of like a typical standard Allen nut. So one thing I have to keep out to the field with me is this driver bolt right here, driver wrench. So as long as I don't forget that, you have no problems. But when I went to fly it the other day, I forgot this, and on the first toss, of course, it didn't go right, and I nosed in, and I had to go home and get this wrench. So maybe one thing to think about, pros versus cons with this race wing, is the fact that if you do forget your wrench and you hit the ground once, you're probably going to be done for the day unless you can sort of use an Allen wrench to make it work. I think the Allen wrench bit will actually fit in there, but how tight you can actually get it with that, I'm not totally sure. Now, aside from all the pros and cons, let's just talk about pros for a second. This is an awesome race wing. It's definitely not a beginner race wing. It is something that is intermediate to advanced, but it flies absolutely awesome when you get this thing all tuned in and squared away with your trims. An amazing flying plane. Very, very subtle on a slower speed. It does have some bounce because it is a smaller wing, but at high throttle, it really smooths out a lot, and it is wicked fast flying at line of sight around the field, and it's actually pretty easy to see. I just have this red sticker over here on the very far end so that I could kind of differentiate between left and right there on this side of the wing, and when it flips over, it's white on the bottom. But it was a nice sunny day when I was testing this, and I could see it totally fine flying at line of sight. Now I'm going to show you real quick how quickly this wing breaks down. These two little bolts loosen up right here, and these two in the back. So for transport, this is awesome. I'm about to take a trip myself, and I was thinking about bringing this along because this is really easy to break down just like that. And these pull out, and you can unplug this wire on this side and this side. And now you're ready to throw it in a backpack, take it on the plane, possibly. This wing there, this wing here, and then you have the center fuselage right here. Look at how cool that is. That's a really cool design. I have plenty of room back here as well if I wanted to add more components on here. If I wanted to add a flight controller, I could add it right in the center right here, And by the way, on Thingiverse, there are some actual mounts that will mount right on here, so you can add a flight controller on here. And you can actually fly this wing in acro mode, which is going to be different than flying it in full manual mode, by the way. For some of you guys that think that manual mode are the same characteristics as acro, not totally true. So it's going to fly really interesting in acro mode. And you can do stabilization and all that other stuff if you're using something like iNav. And iNav is sort of the brainchild of Betaflight and CleanFlight from the last couple of years. You can look up iNav in the Chrome Web Store. It has a lot of bolts on the bottom of here, but it was actually a really quick build. I did it in like an afternoon, so it didn't take long at all. It has plenty of room up front, by the way, for a GoPro camera or a run cam too. You've got tons of space here, and they have two little slots here for running a Velcro strap around. But my recommendation, my biggest recommendation, would probably be to put this somewhere else. It is nice that they have that mount there, but a lot of times this can snap off the antenna if you hit upside down in a hard crash. But I intended, luckily hit the very front bottom of this. That took the biggest impact right there. So 30 amp speed controller was totally fine for this setup on 3 or 4S for my setup. The motor did get a little bit hot, but it was about 105 degrees the day that I was running this for you guys and testing, so it was quite hot outside, but not a bad airframe. I think it's actually a really interesting design. I believe it was also a Kickstarter. Now let's see what the Flybot weighs, just the fuselage alone. 337 grams, probably going to be quite a bit lighter than that without the run cam on there and that extra battery. Let's just take those off real quick and give you a dry weight with the FPV gear on there and my RS2205 back there. The dry weight is 244 grams there. Now we'll put that run cam 2 back on there. And let's go ahead and put the 4S 850 milliamp battery on there. 396. Now let's see if I can balance the wings on there. Get everything on the scale. The total takeoff weight for you guys would be, we're looking at 626 grams. Let's see if I can get that so you can see it. 626 grams. Not bad for a super light little mini race wing. Let's go ahead and let's do a little testing, further testing of this race wing. Let's do some line of sight flying and let's do some FPV.
All right, guys, I am back in my car, and I didn't anticipate coming out here and doing a durability test with this today. I thought I was coming out to give it a spin and fly it for you guys. I had it all tuned in and dialed in and everything, but I guess I didn't have the expo high enough to handle any kind of barrel roll, but it put it straight into the ground from about 100 feet up, pretty much half throttle. So looking along the edge of the fuselage here, I have no cracks, no damage. The only thing that I need to repair, and I could probably go out and do another flight, is this VTX right here. And this is a cheap one anyway. This is actually one of those cheapy China 600 milliwatt VTXs. But this side right here kind of popped loose. So I'm just going to take my TS100 over here, turn it on with my 4S battery. I'm going to solder that back on, that side, and maybe check out these sides too. These look a little bit like a cold solder.
All right, so the wing's back on. It's 98 degrees out, but you know, I'm gonna do another test here. We're gonna do a line of sight test, and I'm gonna show you how fast this wing is. Hopefully I have a good launch. I'm just gonna do a quick little pre-flight checklist. Left, right, up, down, okay? I had to put a lot of trim on one side last time, so hopefully when I launch, it doesn't wing over into the ground, but run cam 2 is recording. Okay, and I'm recording on my Fat Shark goggles and the GoPro for you guys. So here we go again. And that's on 4S. So we're not gonna do any barrel rolls this time. I didn't even bend the prop on that crash. That's kind of amazing. Man, I wanna do a barrel roll. I need to trim back those expo settings so that I have a little more throw. Maybe change up the travel. I have some pretty short servo arms on the wings because I lost one of the longer ones. So I didn't have another one to add on there. So I had to use what I had, but no problem for our demo. This thing is super fast. There's a lot of heat coming off the ground. It seems like the ground is like sucking it down when it gets close to the grass. But it's definitely not a beginner plane by any means. It's definitely intermediate to advanced, but the system works. I've put that wing back on there both sides so many times now, and it saved the system in the crash. And I guess that's what this wing is all about. It's to save your FPV gear, and it actually did that. So I'm kind of stoked about that. The VTX took a hit on the side because it is kind of sticking out the side a little bit in the design. I guess if it was more of an internal design, it might be a little better. But what you can do is mount it somewhere inside and just have the VTX antenna sticking out somewhere else instead of on the side. And that might save your video transmitter in a crash. It's a little bit of wind up there. It's gonna come by and do a nice fast pass. It's smoking. And I bet you that ESC is running super hot right now on 4S and 90 degrees outside, 98 degrees. I'm sure that ESC is well over 100 degrees up there. And right now I'm about half throttle. Just kind of cruising around. Sure you can hear that wind in my GoPro. Hopefully it's not this hot where you guys are. Man, it's hot out today. I was making jokes on Facebook yesterday about how hot it was. I can't really share that joke right now, but you guys that are friends with me on Facebook probably saw it. I'm gonna switch this aircraft over to my FR Sky X7.
so I'll have a little longer range. I've got kind of a park receiver on this right now, Spectrum park receiver. Just taking some turns. Now, it is pretty bumpy flying FPV on this wing, and mainly because it's a small wing, so. But it's really easy to see flying at line of sight. I can really see that wing shape up there. And flight test, they had a good time with theirs. You should go check out their video too. You know about the flight test guys. They had fun with it, but they had some of the same issues I had. Whoa, something's going wrong here. It's like that, there's some real bad downdraft right there over the field. I thought I was going in for sure. I'm sure there's some extremely hot air, so I'm gonna bring it in and set it down before I have any bad accidents over this super hot field. I'm gonna take one more pass. Really sucking hard right there, right in that area right there. Now most drone pilots that fly with fire crews know not to fly directly over a fire. See if I can keep it in one piece. Oh yes, it didn't pop off. Thank God. Just about every time this thing hits the ground, the wings fly off of it. At least one side flies off for me, so. That was pretty cool. You can see how it's kind of off on one side there. It's coming off a little bit, but I guess my only criticism would be that they use these driver bolts instead of using like Allen. It would be nice if they had Allen. But pretty easy wing to fly once you get it trimmed in. Super fast. So I would recommend one of these. Most definitely Flybot. It's a pretty cool wing. It's a good idea for a race wing for FPV. If you're thinking about getting into FPV racing wings, this is not a bad choice. Because I really like this carbon fiber center plate, this fuselage down the center. It makes everything, mounting everything in there really easy for all of the FPV stuff. I had no problem. And that adjustable motor center back there, you can move it out and in and change the CG on the entire plane. So I'll probably set it up a little better now that the flight test is done, but this is definitely going to be my personal FPV wing for this year. So thanks for watching this review of the Mini Race Wing, guys. It's even still flying in 100 degrees outside. Please do subscribe, guys. I'm going to have more awesome videos for you guys on the way. Thanks again for watching. Stay cool out there. Drink some iced tea. I'll see you on the next one.